Having a profession in the oil and gas industry is considered as one of the most dangerous jobs. One wrong decision or the inability to interpret some data may lead to catastrophic events and horrifying fatalities. One of the worst accidents that took place in the century is the Deepwater Horizon accident. Due to a defective seaman job, a leakage in natural gas took place, causing the gas to reach the rig. It triggered an explosion, killing 11% of the crew and causing the sinking of the whole rig. In addition, an estimated spillage of 1,000 barrels oil per day were released to the ocean for 87 days. This means an estimated amount of 87,000 barrels of oil released. This spillage caused severe consequences to the environment and the death of hundreds of sea creatures. All these consequences could have been prevented if they succeeded to shut in and seal off the wellbore correctly. However, the equipment that is specialized to do so malfunctioned and didn't operate correctly. This equipment is called a blowout preventer, or a BOB. It is considered as a secondary barrier in case the primary barrier failed to contain the formation fluids, which is the drilling fluid. The most common configuration of BOB consists of a series of rams. Each ram is designed to do a specific job. These rams are... Number 1. Annular ram. It is designed to shut in the well on any tubular size inside. It can also be closed against itself if the well is empty. However, closing the ram on itself may cause the deterioration of the rubber element that is designed to seal the wellbore. Number 2. Pipe ram. This ram is either fixed or variable. The fixed ram is designed to shut in against a specific size of tubulars, while the variable ram is designed to shut in a series of sizes. However, it cannot shut in the well if any tubular size out of this range is inside the wellbore. It means that a variable ram is more flexible than a fixed pipe ram. However, it is not as flexible as the annular ram. Number 3. Blind ram. This ram is designed to shut in the well when there is nothing inside. This means that it fully closes the full bore size. Number 4. Shear ram. This ram is designed to cut the tubular inside the wellbore. It is used as a last resort in case all other rams failed to contain the situation. Number 5. Blind shear ram. This ram is a combination of both blind and shear rams. It cuts the tubular and seals the wellbore simultaneously. Since the BOB is designed to operate in case of emergency, there must be a separate power source that is responsible for the operation of BOB, which is independent of the rig power system. This power source is called accumulator or a COMI unit. The COMI unit consists of bottles containing a diaphragm which looks like a balloon from the inside. This balloon is filled with nitrogen gas under an initial pressure of 1000 psi. This balloon is then compressed by hydraulic oil to reach a pressure of 3000 psi. This pressure can vary based on the rating of the BOB itself. When the BOB is operated, the hydraulic oil starts to be pumped and pushed through the hydraulic lines to a specific ram to operate. This causes the pressure in the cylinder to drop down. The COMI unit must be equipped with two power sources to regenerate the lost pressure and raise it back to the original value. These two power sources are an electric pump and an air pump. Oil will be withdrawn from an oil tank and pump to the nitrogen cylinder through these two pumps to raise the pressure back to the original value. This means that the pressure gauges on the COMI unit will read a drop in pressure, which eventually increases back to the original pressure in a short time. This way, the COMI unit is always charged and ready to apply more control functions to the BOB equipment. Each ram has two chambers, a closing chamber and an opening chamber. If an action was made to close the ram, hydraulic oil will be pumped to the closing chamber, causing the ram to move to the shut-in position. This will also cause the hydraulic oil which existed in the opening chamber to return back to the oil tank. When an action to open the ram is taken, the opposite process will take place. Hydraulic oil will be pumped to the open chamber, causing the ram to move to the open position. Consequently, the oil that existed in the closing chamber will return back to the oil tank. This way, the hydraulic oil will remain in a closed system. This is also why both opening and closing BOB ramps will cause an instantaneous drop in the COMI unit pressure gauges before it rises up again by both the electric and air pumps of the COMI unit. After a well is shut in, the primary barrier must be restored. This is done by replacing the existing drilling fluid inside the well bore with kill fluid. This is done by many different methods that will be covered in another video. For now, this is basically done by circulation of the kill fluid into the well and the existing drilling fluid out of the well. The part of the BOB stack that is responsible for the circulation is called a drilling spool. A drilling spool is a connector which allows choke and kill lines to be attached to the BOB stack. A kill line is responsible for bumping into the well, while the choke line is responsible for transmitting the flow return from the well to the choke manifold. A choke manifold is an arrangement of valves, pipelines, and chokes designed to control the flow from the well during well cleaning operation. It can either redirect the flow to a flare pit or to the mud gas separator on mud tanks. Two valves are recommended between the BOP stack and the choke manifold. One of these two valves is a hydraulic remote controlled valve, which is called HCR. During normal operations, the HCR is always closed, while it's open during well control operations to allow passage of flow return to the choke manifold. The other valve is an inner manual valve and it's always open. If the HCR needs maintenance, the manual valve will be closed. If there are tubulars inside the well, the BOB will only be able to seal the annulus around it. Therefore, a valve is required to seal the inside of the tubulars. There are two types of valves, a gray valve or an inside BOP, and a full opening safety valve. A full opening safety valve is a full bore valve that is installed open, then switched to the closed position using a special key. While an inside BOB is a one-way valve that allows killing the well while preventing backflow up the drill string. When drilling top hole sections, the formations are still unconsolidated. If the BOB is used and shut in during a kick, the pressure will keep building up, causing the fracture of these formations. Eventually, the formation fluids will escape and reach the surface, causing a blowout. In some extreme cases, the surface casing may jump out of the well during the blowout. The ideal solution during drilling the top hole section is to install a diverter instead. This equipment is not designed to shut in the well, but to divert the flow to a safe distance away from the well until it's successfully killed or the well site is evacuated. In this video, we have discussed the essential equipment used for well control. If you like this video, make sure to press the like button. Also share it with your friends for their benefit. If you want to know more about well control procedures and equipment, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Moreover, drop a comment in the section down below if you want to know more about a specific topic in the oil and gas field. Thanks for watching.